My name is Tom, and welcome to Living Thru Limits. Doing some work out in the yard, and working on a chicken pen that's kind of fallen down. I built a retaining wall. I built it like, originally with a dog pen that went in probably 20 years ago. And the retaining wall is kind of falling over, so we're out there digging a ditch, pulling the retaining wall back up. Went to use my Milwaukee Sawzall, and it's locked up. I've had this Sawzall probably a good, at least 20 years, if not more. I don't even know the model number because it's all worn off of here, off the little plate. But it's one of the first ones with the twist lock cord. I have two of these, and one's a little heavier duty, the other one, and my son-in-law borrowed it, and I don't have it right now. So I figured I better fix this Sawzall. So I've never taken one of these apart, so it's going to be a journey for all of us. So we'll see what we find in here. This, I plugged it in, and it just hums. So let's start taking this apart. This thing's got it's just years of gunk on here. So I think what we're gonna do, since we've gotta take this apart anyhow, we're gonna clean this thing up, hopefully make it as good as new. What I do, I find something that's broken, I change my plans for the day, but you know what? I have the liberty to do that. Got four screws in here that hold this head on here, and they've got a lot of grease and oil and stuff, so we'll clean all that up. I was a plumber for a lot of years, and I think what's happened is between myself and my employees and stuff, these things saw a lot of laying in water and stuff because cutting pipes and stuff. So I really think this is really going to need to have a pretty good cleaning. Hopefully the brushes and everything are still in good shape. These screws, I think the heads, oh that's why, they're almost like a square head. Let me try something a little different here. I've got a little set of screws. Let me see if I can get the square head working there. So what we've got this set that I got years ago. Got different sizes of square drives. These things are a pain to get out. Okay, so I learned something new. These screws come out Vex, even though they kind of look like a Phillips head, they are actually a square drive. Well, let me show you here. It's dirty, but this is a Phillips head, and it takes a Phillips screwdriver, which looks like, let me wipe it off. Okay, it kind of looks like that. Goes in there and it's nice and tight. Okay, these on the other hand, they look like, just glancing at them, they kind of look like a Phillips, and a Phillips will fit in there, but not very tight. So what you have to do is use a square drive, fits right in there, and you don't slip. Okay, it looks like the head wants to pop off of there, which is a good sign, I guess. Oh, we want to get this off of here. This holds the blade. I want to just take an old rag. Oops, I guess it came off. Oh, wow. See, it's got the gears, and it transfers the rotation going from a circular motion, and this goes up and down. So in here, there's a set of gears to change it. But all that's locked up, filthy, and all that, so we're going to take that apart. But we got to clean it. When you're doing this kind of stuff, this is a little magnetic plate. It really makes it nice so you don't lose your screws, as long as you remember to throw your screws in there. Sometimes I have a problem with that.
Let's put this down.
You know, it's funny, you can repurpose a lot of things. This old wood table here, this was a box in my old work van. It has drawers on the front, they're covered right now, but works great for being outside. My garage where I work on a lot of this stuff is so full of stuff right now. I couldn't do this in there if I wanted to. Now the next thing, the driver is a Torx. Now I've got Torx, and Torx is almost like a, I don't know, star drive or something, but it's six pointed.
They don't strip very easy. It makes it really nice. And they have different sizes, so like, and I think I have duplicates. That's a T10, T10, T15. As the number goes up, so does the size. These are all duplicates. This is a T25. The T20 is not in here. Oh, let's see, which one is this?
It's a T10. Let's take this guy off. And that's a cover to cover the O-ring. And I think what I'm going to have to do a little bit is do a little straightening on here. I think over the years somebody has put the guard, which the little foot that runs the blade, and I think we're gonna do some work on it to get it straightened out, get the anvil over here, get it all cleaned up, and see what we can do. But see how bent up and cut up and stuff. I know you can buy a new one, but why? We'll just straighten it all up. Get out the hammer and different things and fix it. It's got a split there. I don't know how the guy did that to it, but we'll get it all fixed up. This is a little seal. It's supposed to keep the grease from coming out. It's broken. I may have to just order some parts off. It's a little felt seal. Maybe order some parts. Huh. Is that metal or is that... it's just grease.
If you find metal, that's a bad thing. If you find grease, let me clean that up. I have to get my little snap ring pliers. I don't know if this all comes out as one unit, but we're going to find out.
See, there's a couple of screws in here. One here.
That's, really loose. I guess you should service these more than every 25 years. I'm usually not that bad with my tools. These are really loose. Good thing this whole thing didn't come apart.
When you're gonna kinda give some persuasion, you wanna be careful. You don't wanna break something. But this is all froze up. Now that came out really easily. Make sure there's nothing in here. There's a bearing down in here. This is all full of grease. Hopefully I didn't bunch it up. Okay, now I had mentioned I think what I want to do, because I don't have a schematic on this, and I want to make sure we put it all back together correctly. I think I'm going to get out my phone here, take some pictures. And right now it's really greasy, but before I start cleaning it, and just in case something falls apart, this is a shaft that goes up and down. This is a bearing and a shaft. This looks like a problem. I gotta figure out what that is. That is a piece of metal. That shouldn't be like that. I think what's happened is, you can see here, there's probably something holding that bearing, but we'll take, there's a snap ring right here. We're going to take that off, which will let us take this gear, which this gear, oh, that's all chewed up. There's a gear on here to transfer the power from going a circle to up and down. And this gear is rough in some areas, and so it's gotten some really nasty wear on it. We may have to see if we can replace that too. This may not get fixed all in one day. So I'm going to get the snap ring pliers. We're going to move ahead. And one snap ring. So now, put that in there. We can maybe take this gear off. Okay, there looks like a little key in here. So I'm just gonna hold this up, tap this a little bit. Doesn't feel too good on the fingers. Piece is broken. I think that is what's all. Oh, that piece is broken. Shoot, I don't know if this thing's salvageable or not, but you know what? We're going to continue cleaning it up. And,
let me see the broken part.
See this right here? This right here is broken. So, may have to see if I can get a new piece. Oh, you know what? It's got another snap ring. So I think what we're going to do, I'm going to take that snap ring, see if we can get this, the center out of here. This has been marred up from something. So we got to fix that. But may have to order a new part from Milwaukee. But let me get my snap ring pliers in there. Okay, now this snap ring works the opposite. Instead of pulling it apart to get it off a shaft, this one, I got to change the configuration of this because I have to compress the ring to get it out. So this is nice. This has a quick change. So you just compress it, pull it over, pull the pin out, remove this from this side, put it on this side. Back down through here, Now, I can use it that way. Sometimes you have to just kind of help it out a little bit. And we got the snap ring out. Oh, sorry. We have the snap ring out.
The shaft, even though the gear and this thing are parallel to each other, as it spins, this piece, right?
Oh, this piece. This piece. It goes up and down. Well, with this seized, this bearing seized in that shaft may not be any good anymore. All it wants to do is completely just spin all the way around. Well, you can't do that.
Let's see. And we were able to get this out. Okay, so the piece that was all broken up in here, that's the bearing.
That's the inner race of the bearing. So that's no big deal. Because when you get a new bearing, you're going to get all that. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get the bearing out of this piece. This piece is pretty worn here. On this, where it goes into the shaft that goes up and down. And that's the center marks. I probably could take a punch and from the back side try to punch that bearing out. I might be able to just go on Amazon. I got the bearing number right there. Might be able to get new bearings. Or I could contact Milwaukee direct.
But I think what we're gonna do, clean all this grease off. I'm gonna get my little pan that is from a garage sale. Little stainless steel kitchen pan or bowl. They work so good when you pay a buck and you can use them for cleaning things up. I'm hoping this casting is not, I may clean it up a little bit. Well, get all the grease off of it and everything. I gotta check that bushing out in here. So now, with this kind of taken apart, you can see how that shaft is.
It's designed as it rotates, it goes up and down. The bearing sitting in here, so when you figure, it makes that go up and down, which in return with this bearing, because this sits in a solid pilot inside here, right there, and that's on an angle, and that's been worn. So we'll get all that cleaned out, and when we get this all cleaned up, we'll get back to you. Well, we're back on the Sawzall, and sometimes you have to make a decision, especially when you're living on a real tight budget, to just not go any further on a project. So this Sawzall, we are actually gonna keep for parts. I have another one, and I think at my mom and dad's I have another, so I have a couple of them. And one of the things I found, is this is the armature for the motor that drives this Sawzall. And on the end of this armature, there's a, I guess you would call it a worm gear. But if you look really carefully, this gear is worn instead of being like a real thick gear to where it meshes with the other gear that does the drive. This gear has worn really, really thin. Well, and it's got chips in it, and I don't know if you can see that on camera, but there's a chip there and a chip there, and it's almost like a thin as a knife blade. Well, what's gonna happen is that whole thing's gonna break off. So, I got on the old interweb, internet, whatever, and Googled these bearings. These are sealed bearings. As you can see on this side, it's got a seal. This one's greasy. This side, it's come apart, and I've got two or three bearings that have gone bad. Well, you look at the prices of those bearings, and they're like $13 a piece. And if I need, you know, three of them, that's what, $39 plus tax and all that. This thing, I didn't even look up. I know it's not cheap. You can buy a whole new Sawzall, especially you can buy a used one for under $100. And I, like I said, I have another one. So I'm gonna use this for parts. And so the foot on this thing, it's in pretty bad shape too. The metal's actually split here. You can see here, it's all dented up. So we're gonna call this one a basket case. We have a switch we can use if the other switch in my Sawzall goes bad, and we're just gonna keep this for parts. Oh, let me show you one other thing that had went bad. This thing had a bearing that's for the tailpiece of this, it's kind of like a, almost like a crankshaft, but this is offset to where it runs the reciprocating part of the Sawzall going up and down. Well, that bearing, that goes into a bearing that sits in here, and that bearing had gone bad, and it wore the casting, the aluminum casting out, and wore it all crooked. So it just isn't feasible to put this thing back together. So when you're on a tight budget, and you know, you just really have to look at things. One, this is not an antique tool. This tool can still be, you can still pick this Sawzall up, and there are some good parts in here we can use for other things. So, you know, it's a judgment call sometimes. So I want to thank you for watching this video. I'd like to ask you to subscribe to my channel, leave me a comment. I'm still waiting for, I don't know how many videos I've done, and not one person's commented on my channel yet. But I, you know, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And just remember, you too can live through your limits. Thank you.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.